flywheel cowling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fixing points. This one's a bummer. This one's bottomed out. Here's a shorter bolt. Screw broken off. This one, thread stripped. This one also. So basically this flywheel cowling has been held on by top and bottom. Probably won't see it, but a lot of screw was put in this hole and it's threaded on the casing a bit, which is what was holding it in. So I'm going to try and tap that out to M6 and this one out to M6. I'm rejigging this video, so you might notice some joins. Tap the holes out with a 6mm tap. The taper tap bottomed out on the side of the casing here, so finished it with a plug tap. This one also. I found the tap wrench didn't really want to go in straight here. I just used vice grips to turn it. It's soft metal, so it's not difficult. The sheer bolt in this hole was actually stainless, so I bought some 2-pack cobalt drills from Tool Station and drilled it out at a slow speed. Filed it flat, gave it a centre dab and had a go at drilling it. Problem is, drills don't want to go in straight and I'm not into taking all this apart to get them home, so I'm going with this. I have a toolkit from years on the building side. 5mm hole, 4.2 drill for tapping a 5mm hole, so this is a 2.5 drill. It broke through. So what to do now? I think I'm going to try and drift it out. Knock the centre dab in after I've chopped the screw off. Not sure it's doing any good to the threads. Let's see with a 4mm drill. Now I'm going to try a 5mm tap. Oh, there you go, that screw's moving now. There you go, that's out now. Yeah. Okay. So the next thing to do is I'll just drill that out. Well, I won't drill it out, I'll just give it a tap. With a 6mm tap like the other two holes. Get a 6mm friction. Stainless steel. Should be drilled at a slow speed. Turn it down. I can control it with the trigger as well. Had a sheared bolt and A-bar. Stainless. Had to drill it out. 2.5 cobalt drill for stainless steel. Not a great exercise to do in this scooter. The drill's disappearing up inside the chuck. Oh, there you go. So, that took all of 3 minutes, I would think. But it worked. I never thought to try this in A-bar. I bought a set of these screw extractors. They're anti-clockwise. And what I can gather, you can hammer them in a little bit. Don't know if the tap wrench will do it. There you go, it's turning it out. I thought it would because the threads are brand new. I don't know how it would work with rusty or corroded bolts. Plenty of penetrating spray, I think. Now I'm going to put the flywheel cowling back on, hopefully securely, because as everybody knows, it's an important part of the air cooling system. The air is dragged in, the flywheel acts like a dredger, dredging the air around, spin out here through the fins in the cylinder and cooling the engine. And until recently, I was unaware of that. Had the cover off, clutch out and in to fit a new drive chain, new kickstart return spring, snugged up the flywheel cowling, fired it up, and it's screeching like a dive bombing bat out of hell. Scary. What have I done? Was it the clutch? Was it the chain? It was the flywheel. Scratching on the inside of this. So I took it off, dressed it with a hammer and some wood, put it back on. Much improved, but still noisy. So I'm going to go for plan B. Flywheel cowling, plan B, was to put it over this old tin paint and give it another hammering. But working on the other scooter, I reached the point where I wanted to check the timing and the starter plate. And holding tools and impact wrenches started to get a mention. So I gave the flywheel nut on the other scoot a rattle, came off no problems. Then I put it on reverse, gave this one a rattle, and it seems to have tightened up a couple more threads. Anyway, the result is, I've had this on, fixed all around, the screeching's gone, you live and learn. Many months after banishing the bat from hell, a post popped up on Lambretta Rebuild concerning lay shaft failure. I presume that means fractioning. This is the end of the lay shaft. The gears are on the other end, a definite stress area. The comments section then brought up case for over tensioning being a possible contributory factor. That caused me to reflect a little. There are torque settings in Stickies and Haynes for just about every nut and bolt. None that I can find in here. This is the flywheel nut. Threads onto the camshaft. Clamps the flywheel in place. In the interest of filming, it's been rattled a lot more than once with this impact gun. And then a continuous tightening motion. Torque setting, end these guess. Well, and set a gauge to get a click. And I'm pretty uneducated in torque. So I googled it. I would presume anyone daring to watch this is something of a novice. So here's the lowdown. Torque, also called amount of force, it's the tendency of force to rotate an object to which it is applied. Also a measure of such force. And when more tightened, the thread converts the applied torque into tension on the bolt shank. This in turn is converted into a clamping force. The amount of tension created is critical. My understanding at the moment is when you tighten a nut up, you stretch the threads a little to basically make a solid bolt spring loaded, creating a perfect clamping force between too loose and too tight. Basically, torque is the sweet spot in between. The clamping force is too high, the fastener may be permanently stretched, distorted, and no longer apply the correct clamping force. It'll also mess you up. If you ever try and torque it again, it won't work. In severe cases, it may fail in assembly or during use when under load. If too low, the fastener can work loose due to vibration, leading to possible failure. The correct torque therefore creates a harmony. Harmony is good. The Temptations had it. We want harmony. So in the interest of science, I've purchased this. A beam wrench. It's 23rd of October, 2020. Money appears to grow in trees. I remain unconvinced. And I'm looking to splash out any more than I have to check on one anti-clockwise bolt. This, relatively cheap, works in both directions, accurate to within 4 degrees. My original thought process was that if I put it on here and broke the nut loose, I would get a reverse reading. Seems that's not the case. It can take 2.5 times the effort to break a nut loose. to tighten it. So this may not be a good idea. I'm going to get the holding tool, put a few marks on here, and try and tighten it a fraction to get the reading. So I've marked the gauge at 55 foot-pounds, which is the MB setting, torque setting. Flywheel nut appears to have moved the fraction, and not too far off the 55 foot-pound mark. Now I'm going to remove the flywheel 100%, let it chill for 24 hours, then I'll refit it. Also Loctite in the hard shoulder, torque it correctly, and check for screech.
Well, check for screech. Screech is good. On the 23rd of September. That is amazing. Not October. And the ongoing insanity. The days have been rolling into one. Now the months are. And to begin from this little episode, I learned, maybe he's I, maybe he's not. However, on the plus side, the world of untorking allows me to introduce an old buddy, the Bat Out of Hell.
And I bring you fire.
Save us now.